Hello everyone, welcome back to YK Reviews, welcome back to the Saw Retrospective Reviews series, where today we're talking about Saw 2, the sequel to the first Saw movie. So let's get straight into it here. So yes, we are going to be reviewing all the Saw movies now. And again, I know that there are some videos out there reviewing all the Saw movies. This is going to be the retrospective reviews for all the Saw movies. So I appreciate you taking the time to be watching this video. I have posted my review for the first Saw movie. So I'll post that somewhere around here. So you can definitely check out my thoughts on the first movie. And also let me know your thoughts about everything as well in the comment section down below. And if you are new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button. We're doing reviews for all the Saw movies, and along with a tier ranking video at the end of the month when Saw 10 comes out. So definitely stick around, definitely subscribe so that you're not missing out on that. But with today's video, it's going to be all about Saw 2, the sequel to the Saw movie, where things are definitely have been dialed up when it comes to the traps, when it comes to the gore, when it comes to like the violence. Because the movie straight away kicks off with one of the most disturbing traps for me, is that you have this person who is stuck in this room. He's got this contraption in his head, and we see the tape where the key to the contraption is behind his eye, so he has to literally cut his eye open in order for him to get the key. But obviously he's not able to do that, and then the whole trap just starts squishing his head, and it's, I believe it's called the Venus flytrap. I could be wrong. It's either the Venus flytrap or the bear trap, but I could be wrong. So if I am, just please let me know in the comment section down below. But just a gruesome way to just kick off the movie. And then we get introduced to the main character who's going to be playing off of Jigsaw, John Kramer. We get introduced to Detective Matthews and his son, and you sort of see this relationship building in terms of like how they are. He looks like he's divorced, and his son, he's got like part custody, or I'm not sure what exactly the term is. The son is sort of like rebelling, he's stealing things, he's Detective Matthews is the one having to bail him out. They have like this big argument where the kid says he wants to go stay at his mum, and the detective wasn't too happy with his choice of words, again getting into an argument, and he ends up getting called to the crime scene where Jigsaw is apparently calling him. So he is Jigsaw's next victim, and that's where we also get introduced to Carrie, who was in the first movie, which she wasn't really like a main role or anything like that. She was sort of there as part of the police force, but she and Detective Matthews are being called to the crime scene, where they come to figure out that Jigsaw is calling out Detective Matthews to come face to face with him. So they end up finding out Jigsaw's lair, John Kramer's lair, and that's where we get introduced to this face to face with John Kramer and Detective Matthews. And with the movie in itself, it sort of like switches back and forth. So you've basically got two settings. So you've got the first setting, which is the police and the SWAT team and Kerry and Detective Matthews with John Kramer in the room in the lair. And then the second location is when you've got these people in this house as part of like this Saw game that they have to play. So I want to first focus on the first location when it comes to Detective Matthews and Jigsaw, John Kramer, because John Kramer was just so clever in his dialogue. So he basically confirms that he has stolen or kidnapped Detective Matthews' son. So he's sort of playing mind games with him. John Kramer is really simple when it comes to what he plans for his victims. All he says that he wants to play a game, he explains the rules, and you have to be really clever to understand the way in order to outsmart or survive Jigsaw's game. With this one, very simple, is to just keep talking, and then when the timer runs out, he'll be able to find his son. So just really, really simple things. But obviously, with his son being kidnapped, he wants to find his son as quickly as possible. That's Detective Matthews, that is. But you just have this dialogue back and forth. Obviously, the SWAT team are there. They're focusing on like these monitors, this camera that's actually, you can see Detective Matthews' son and these other kids or adults that are playing this Saw game. But when it comes to the two of them, their back and forth dialogue was just really spot on and just so fun to watch. Again, a little bit of, you could say, dialogue heavy, but it's just the way it is being built up, and it's being built up towards the third act, which really plays off so well and just comes together really well with everything that's going on, even to the point where you just see Detective Matthews just beat the crap out of John Kramer, which was just so fun. Like, you just see this old man just get beaten up by this detective, which is, I don't know why, it just cracked me up so much, but that element is there. So then we move towards the second location, and that's pretty much where the main focus is when it comes to the Saw traps. So you have a bunch of characters that are waking up in the room to find themselves stuck in this room with one another. Amanda, the victim from the first movie, has returned with just a ridiculous haircut. You've got the detective son in there along with a couple of other characters who apparently they all have something in common. Now, you think the first thought would be that they either are doing drugs or that they have done drugs in the past or that they all come from prison because they talk about that. But with Amanda freaking out, realizing that she's back in this Saw games, they try to find out how to escape. One of the person that gets killed off, which I honestly can't remember his name, he ends up getting shot in the eye by a gun from behind the barrel of the door because Xavier, I believe his name was, is just in such a hurry to get out that he ends up opening the door and the gun just shoots the other guy in the eye and ends up dead. But the main point of the game is that they need to find an antidote because they've been breathing in some toxic gas or toxic air or whatever it was. So around the house, they have to find the antidote, which is where they end up going into like these Saw traps. So one of the main Saw traps was for Obi, I believe his name was. And we come to find out that it's in this little like fire chamber. There's two antidotes there. So Obi is the one that goes inside. The door ends up closing and the fire starts opening up. So he's basically getting burnt alive. The antidote is basically done and dusted because of the fire. So he essentially is getting burnt and that's the end of Obi. And so as the movie is progressing, as they're going through the traps, one of the most disturbing traps was one with the needles pit of needles where one antidote is in there and Xavier, the guy that ends up costing the first victim his life, he ends up throwing Amanda in this hole full of needles and you just see this disturbing sequence of like her just injected with so much needles around her. She ends up finding the antidote and it's just like some messed up scene, but like all these other victims are just like struggling with their bodies breaking down. Xavier's really struggling. He ends up killing Jonas when they have like this little sequence of them going back and forth. I believe one of the victims, she just couldn't live on and I think she just ends up dying in the hallway. Another one, she ends up trying to find an antidote in like this glass jar and she has to put her hands through this glass and she ends up getting stuck and the antidote is also just like spreads out everywhere so she doesn't even get the antidote. So everybody's just like freaking out, not being able to get the antidote, just getting killed off. We come to find out that the reason why they're in there, the reason that they've all been brought together is because they have all been arrested by Detective Matthews. So his son is in there and his father has been arrested all these people, which they come to find out Xavier finds a picture of Detective Matthews and his son and is on a rampage. So I think everybody at this point is being killed off other than Xavier, Amanda and the detective's son. I forgot his name, Daniel, I believe it was. So this little goose chase happens throughout the movie. So you've got Xavier chasing after Amanda and the son, Daniel. They end up going into the original room where they all woke up in to find like this trap door on the floor. They end up escaping Xavier. And that's when you get this whole third act. Like everything with the third act was just so chaotic because you come to find out that Jigsaw, John Kramer, convinces this Detective Matthews to follow him, like he'll take him to his son. So you've got like the police and the SWAT going after one location. You've got Detective Matthews in one location. You've got Amanda and his son in the location. So everything is just going, cutting back and forth to different locations, different characters and where they are at that point in time. So to just cut everything really quickly, the police and the SWAT end up in the wrong house where they come to find out that the camera and the monitor that Kerry and the police officers were at John Kramer's lair, what they were watching was not live at all. It was all pre-recorded, video recorded. So it comes to find out that they had not been watching anything live and the timeline is completely different. We then come to see Xavier getting into the same bathroom where that's where, again, you see Adam's body there from the first movie. So that same bathroom sequence, Amanda pretends that Daniel is dead. Xavier has been literally going around trying to get numbers off everybody's back of their neck for the combination of the safe. And so he ends up doing this disturbing thing of using the knife and cutting his own skin off the back of the neck to get the number here. But Daniel ends up like tricking him. He ends up alive and he ends up slitting the throat of Xavier. And then we get to Detective Matthew. He's in the same house, but this is in a different time frame. So this is coming later on because he sees all these bodies on the floor. They look like they have been there a while. He ends up going into the same bathroom. But again, he sees Xavier's body there. He sees Adam's body there. And this is taking place maybe, I don't know, a few hours, a few days after the events that took place. And with the score that's taking place, the same score as the third act in the first movie. So it comes to find out that he gets injected because he goes to the same bathtub. It's been revealed that Amanda's the one that injected him. He ends up being trapped the same way that Dr. Gordon and Adam was trapped, with his foot being like chained up. And Amanda locks the door to the bathroom with it being revealed that Detective Matthews was the one that actually arrested her. So all this just taking place, and again, like the score coming through, the cutting between everything, even when they go to the bathroom for the first time, you get the dialogue from the first movie being played, just everything interwoven and connecting so perfectly. It's just such a fun ride that you go on when you transition to the third act. It really is such a great joy to watch and so entertaining. So I really, really enjoyed that whole third act. Not as much as I did with the first movie, but I really had a great time with this. There was some slow pacing when it comes to the second act, and the characters, when it comes to like them in part of the trap, wasn't as strong as it could have been. Like some of the characters, honestly, you're not really that following that much. You don't care whether they live or die. But in terms of like the whole detective and the police aspect of it, I really, really like that storytelling there. And especially as like they were getting through the movie, as they were getting towards the third act, the intensity just rose up. Again, not the most goriest when it comes to like the traps, when compared to like the first part of the movie, the very first opening sequence with the Venus flytrap, I think it was. Some of them were slightly tamer. You've got like the fire pit, you've got the needles, and you've got like the glass in the jar kind of thing. So not too much gore. But it's still just a great movie nonetheless, a really great follow-up to the first movie. Such a great ride, such a great enjoyable watch. I had a fun time with this movie. And then what builds up towards like the upcoming movies, like especially with Detective Matthews, like my God, this guy. I'll talk about more of him later on as the movies progress, but what are your thoughts about this? Let me know in the comment section down below. Have you seen the movie? Did you enjoy it? What your thoughts are about the third act and all the reveals? Let me know in the comment section down below. But that wraps up the second movie of the Saw franchise. So lots more movies still to come. So definitely subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on those upcoming retrospective reviews. But I still want to know your thoughts on everything that we've discussed so far. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening. This is YK Reviews. Peace.